Hey guys, welcome to Mishi Blue Tarot. Welcome to my channel. So today, with the full moon happening and every other thing around, I think I was feeling a little like the energies in terms of being a little bit philosophical, or however you want to put it. I don't know if you can sense it. I mean, I see this thing in me whenever I am thinking a little too much. My voice also tends to become a little heavy. I don't usually want to talk much. But yeah, that's how it is. So today's question is somewhat inspired by that. And this question is, what's next in your journey? I am not like going to be looking at love, career, finances, anything. This is just your journey. And life is a journey. So we'll try to see what the cards have to say. So I don't like to look too far off, but let's see what's coming ahead in probably the next 2 or 3 months or so. I mean, you can keep a time frame in mind, but don't go a little too ahead because then it becomes a little difficult. So you can keep a time frame in your mind, but just make sure that it is close, like 2 months, 2.5 months. What can you expect? So I have laid out 3 piles for you here. So pile one is going to be this amethyst rock. Pile two is going to be the rose quartz wand. And pile three is going to be the labradorite flower. Okay. So timestamps are mentioned in the description, so please go ahead and look at your reading, whichever one you choose. And let's begin. We'll start with number one, the amethyst. But before that, I'll pause for 2-3 seconds for you guys to choose your piles, okay? All right, let's begin with pile one. Okay, so let's see, pile one, what's coming ahead in your journey, like in general, what's coming ahead, what can you expect? So here is the amethyst rock, whoever chose it. Let's see, what's coming ahead or what's next in your journey? The moonlight. Fulfillment of wishes and wisdom. Beautiful energy. Okay, so here, pile number one. Definitely some dream of yours is going to come true. Around September, you will see it happening. There is a little bit of patience required from your end. And this time is not actually just all about being only patient and pause. No, it's about a lot of learning also. I'm seeing that you are evolving as a person, and you are also, I think, in general, you might notice that the way you are growing is very different. Like the way you're thinking or the way you are acting upon things could be very different from your usual self, like what you did probably, okay? I'm also seeing that, yes, this full moon, definitely, that's the reason why I wanted to do this reading, is having some sort of an impact on you for sure. Okay. I don't see you feeling restless or anything, not at all. All right. You're just, this full moon is blessing you with some sort of a patience or some kind of a vision, which is making you patient. You are not exactly feeling restless. You are like, you're like, okay, I can see something for myself. Like that part of it is kind of clear. And that's the energy that I see you in. You're not in a rush. Okay. And I feel that there are a lot of people looking up to you in general. Okay. The way you are, your personality, and every other thing. Okay. I see that there are a lot of people admiring you. There are a lot of people looking up to you because maybe you are in this phase where you are achieving a lot. and your wishes are coming true. And whatever time frame you thought, I am seeing a time frame of next 2 months. Some wish of yours is going to come true. That's what I see. Now, let me pick some more cards. Or no, wait. Let me first clarify each of these and then we can see some more. Let's clarify the moonlight first. What is the moonlight about? What is the moonlight about? The star. Another, again, this is a dream that you have and now you are patient, I feel. And the universe is also trying to tell you that just be patient. This dream will come true. Let's see what is this wish fulfillment card about. Fulfillment of wishes. This is usually the Nine of Cups. Let's see what this is about. Page of Wands, okay. And Six of Wands and Two of Swords. So you will get the clarity to move in a particular direction. And you're going to take small steps. And it is like a dream come true. These small steps will only set the foundation for a higher dimension for you. Like in terms of what you've truly wanted from your heart. This could be something to do with whatever this thing is, just ignites you very passionately from inside. Okay? Let's see what is the wisdom card here for. Let's clarify the wisdom card. Knight of Swords and Three of Pentacles and Four of Wands. So these cards here are telling me that you're not rushing into anything. And that is what it takes to be a mature person, okay? You're going to be working on things in a very, very practical way, very logical way. You're not going to rush into things. You're going to make sure that you're doing something in the right way. Okay? And I'm actually seeing that your patience is going to get you the rewards. That is what I'm seeing. This is something, whatever this thing is that you've been trying to get in your life or manifest in your life, it's coming, but it will come with a lot of patience that you need to practice. I feel that the next 2 months, you will see huge changes, huge changes. I also feel that somewhere you will not be looking at any other thing but just this and just think that this is your happiness, so you should pursue this. Okay, there might be a little element of guilt in the background. I don't know why, but I sense that, so I'm telling you. A little element of guilt in the background, but it's little. It doesn't play a huge role and it shouldn't. If you're feeling happy about something, you should pursue it. Okay? Let's see. What's ahead or what's next in your journey? Let's see what are the other cards that you pick up. What's next in your journey, pile one? Three of Pentacles, Queen of Wands, and I have the Magician, which is the witch in this deck. You're going to make it happen. You will be working with someone on something and you're going to make it happen. Financially, I see you very strong, okay? But then, yeah. I do feel that your love life somewhere, you want something, but you're not going towards it, thinking about your responsibilities or something. Let me know if this is resonating with you. Because I see that energy. I feel that you will be getting what you want. All right? You will be working towards it and you'll make sure you have it. Okay? I do see that you have a plan in mind and you are like in a very, very strong manifestational energy. Okay? You are working on it. It's not like you're just... You're working and you are also patient, all right? So that's a very good combination. I see you becoming financially very strong as well. And that's what is coming ahead. Your passion is what is going to take you forward. So just remember one thing. Anything that ignites your passion from inside, anything that makes you very, very strong and just motivates you from inside that, yes, you want to do this, don't stop yourself. Okay? Don't. Let's see. What else? What's next in your journey? Journey pile one. Four of Pentacles. Whatever this thing is, this is a secret which is very deep inside you. Maybe a lot of people don't know about it. The Tower. But I think it'll come in the limelight. Look at this, Queen of Chalices again. It will come in the limelight because of the kind of emotions you have for this thing. Okay? I am seeing that. And it is going to be a tower moment of sorts where you're trying to hide it, but the emotions will grow so strong that it will come in the public eye. It will come in the public eye. For a lot of you, if this is to do with a person, okay, then I'm seeing that this person will bring you in the public eye, like will accept you publicly, because I'm seeing that it cannot be hidden. It's something very strong. So a very, very nice energy is what I'm picking up, pile number one for you. Okay, it doesn't look like to me that there is anything for you to worry about, or just the way you are, you gotta keep being the way you are. And what's coming ahead is a wish coming true. A dream of yours, which you always wanted, will be coming true. And you've been, and it's because of your, determination, one, and second, your passion towards it, that you never gave up. And also, I'm seeing you achieving what you want. So that's a very beautiful energy that I pick up from here. Let's see an advice for you. What's the advice for pile one? Round and round. Happy, happy. So if this is a situation that, look at this, is 25 and this is 26. So I'm seeing that if you had been going in circles about something, okay, you'll finally figure it out and you will get to your happiness, okay? You are breaking free from a pattern, I feel, pile one. You will be breaking this chain of not... of something that you've been doing and repeating a number of times, that chain is breaking for good, okay? And there is happiness now in your life coming ahead. Yes, you will see the change in 2 months, pile two, pile one. That's what I'm seeing. All right? Okay, so that's what I have for you, pile number one. Guys, I wanted to make a small announcement. I have started a page for crystals. Have a look at it. I will be doing some giveaways over there as well, along with some oracle readings sometime. So you can check that out. And I mean, just if you like it, please follow and subscribe that, because you'll get to see a lot of information about crystal healing. And private readings are open, so you can reach out to me for the same as well. And thank you so much for watching. Please let me know in the comments if this resonated with you. I would love to hear from you. Take care and bye. Okay, now let's move to pile two. Whoever chose this rose quartz wand. So let's see what's next in your journey. What's coming ahead for you? The magic stream. Firm foundation. Oh wow, lovely. I see two number four cards here. So definitely a stable foundation coming your way very soon. Okay. For a lot of you, I feel that if you think that something can give you happiness and you feel that it is a mirage, no, it's not. Listen to your heart. Okay. I can see that this situation, whatever this is involving a lot of your heart space. Okay. And this is practical at the same time, it is logical, pile two. So you have nothing to worry about here. I can see that this could be a man coming in your life who's bringing in a lot of stability, or a woman for that matter. Where you actually feel, or you start to feel that dreams come true. Okay. A magic stream card here, this is card number 9. It just tells me that finally you will have the strength to look through things, to look beyond certain aspects and clear your vision in a very different way. I also feel this can come across like a surprise. Okay, this might have been there in your life for some time, but now it's like a surprise. Whenever you sit to think, you might be taken aback that how can this even happen? All right, but again, this is very close to your heart. This I can see, and it is giving me a sense of feeling very strongly connected to something. This person, or if this is a person, if this is a person, this could also be a career situation, guys. But you would know your wants and your desires better than what I would. So if you're expecting a career to give you stability, it is. If you think that, you know, it is difficult for you to look through a stable future in that particular dimension, then no, it is stable. It's only your way of looking at it that is blocking your vision. But if this is a person, I'm seeing that this person could be turning their back and not actually showing you their true intentions. But deep down, this person really wants to form something stable with you. And their heart is involved in this situation. Okay? Maybe they're not making it quite vocal here. That's what I'm seeing. All right? Now let's clarify each of these cards. Magic stream. Magic stream here for Four of Pentacles. Yes, clearly you were holding yourself back. Another four, something to do with number four, guys. For you might be holding yourself back thinking it is not practical. You were not investing your thoughts thinking it is not practical. You were scared of the practicality part of it. Okay, another four. What's wrong with But again, this is also Four of Wands. Here also I have Four of Wands and I have the Knight of Swords. So guys, this is something that is stable. It's not like something in the air. So it's not that you shouldn't be believing in it at all. It's nothing like that, okay? All you're being asked to is not rush into it very, very fast. Give it time and let it go slowly. Plan it very practically. Plan it very practically. Let's see what is the Heart Chakra card here. Six of Cups. probably it takes you back to a zone of your old self, and maybe you were someone who probably was a very romantic person in the past, and you really took all your decisions from your heart and it did not take you anywhere. So now here you are, another version, but it's here for a purpose. You changed, we appreciate that. A change is always important, but then again a change is also important at the right time. So here, if you probably feel that no, I'm not gonna do that, I am not that, or I feel like laughing, sorry. Because I've seen it, usually with a lot of people, a lot of people are very resistant to change. So here, what I see is, it's here at the right time for you to change. Because if you don't now, it's the law of nature. You got to do it right now. If you don't, then you're losing out on a very huge and a very good opportunity that probably subconsciously you had been manifesting in your life. And then you're going to regret it again. So what is the point? Okay? So if there are fears associated with this situation that, you know, it is going to make you stupid, or it is going to make you look like, no, this is not me, I cannot be this way. If it is going to make you like that, then please take that out of your mind. It is not going to make you like that. Okay? It's actually, why you are seeing this in front of you is so that you take a leap of faith. Sometimes you should trust your instincts, okay, because they are the biggest guide for you. I see that you should move in this direction. All right, let's see what else is ahead of you. What's coming ahead in your journey? Ahead in your journey. Nine of Wands, see, the guarding, the very strong guarding. Six of Cups again, and this guarding could be because of your past. You feel that, you know, you had opened yourself up to this person or this situation in the past and it didn't work out in your favor. So now you're just very scared. You're just very scared here. I feel you're trying all your ways and everything in your mind to not really let your guard down, but it's happening. So you can keep trying your stunts. Six of Swords. You ultimately move in this direction. Nine of Chalices and the Battle Wagon. This seems to me like a girl and a boy, or a masculine and a feminine energy, where the two of you got to come towards each other, because I think the feminine is a very strong manifester who can literally make things happen. So I see that it will take you in a path of success. You just got to take this little risk. Okay? That's what I see. Now, let's see what else do we pick up for you, because guarding is not the solution. See, when you're feeling like putting your guard down, then definitely guarding is not the solution, right? What's coming ahead in your journey? What's next in your journey? Let's see. Eight of Pentacles. Your plans will work out. The Empress, see, I told you, your plans will work out and you will be at the right place at the right time. You just got to be carefree right now. Okay, just be a little carefree. The only thing that you need to do at this point is just make sure that you're not being very impulsive. Be carefree, enjoy yourself, but also keep a check on yourself. Because maybe the last time you did it, but you did not keep a check on yourself. That is the problem. Let's see, pile two. What is the advice for you here in this situation? free advice for pile two. Breathe. Yes, don't stress so much over this situation. You will get to know and you will get the clarity. I think meditation is something that you're being called to do. If possible, please hold an amethyst crystal and meditate. You will understand, or probably a citrine stone, either of the two. I feel that you will get a lot of clarity if you do that. I see that your dreams are coming true. I see that it's basically, you will not be unsuccessful in this. So stop comparing apples to oranges. That is the problem that is happening here. Otherwise, rest, everything is fine and in place. Okay, pile two. So that's what I have for you guys. A small announcement, guys. I have created a channel for crystals on Instagram. It's called MishiBlue_merchandise. So you can have a look at that. You will find all the information regarding crystals over there, because I have received a lot of emails from all of you to know which crystal would be good for you or not. So you can go there, follow that page. You'll be able to see all the information over there. All right. Also, guys, private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. And please let me know if this reading resonated with your situation. I really hope it does. Take care. Bye. Okay, so now let's begin with the labradorite flower, whoever chose this crystal. Okay, so let's see what's coming ahead or what's next in your journey. I've just picked up three oracle cards. I'll be picking tarot cards to see more. Dry desert, heartache and loss, mental conflict. Okay. Don't worry, guys. Relax. Please relax. You got to spend some time alone to resolve your problems. You've been going through a lot, pile three, whoever's chosen this. There's a lot going on inside your mind, and probably you pretend that you're not sad, but you actually are. There is something that is bothering you, but you don't want to acknowledge it and accept it. I feel that your loneliness is killing you. You got to stop being alone. Okay, pile three. I feel the more you will stay alone, the more you will be closer to your heartache. Okay. Spend time alone to figure out the reason for your conflict, but don't become antisocial. That's what I'm saying. The more you do that, like for example, say in a day there are 24 hours, out of which 8 hours we sleep, 8 or 9 hours, chalo. Okay, and the remaining time you're working or doing something. So in that remaining time, so 24 minus 8 is 16 hours. I make it 15. And in that 15 hours, you are probably working for 8 hours or whatever. So in that time that you are free, just make sure you take out 1 hour just to give to yourself to think. Okay, because I feel that you're feeling a sense of loneliness or conflict which you don't know the reason for, and you want to figure that out for yourself. Okay, so you're being advised to figure out the reason and address it right away, otherwise this can become an ache. All right, please understand this thing. You could be thinking that the reason is this, but it actually is not that. It could be something else. So you got to address that something else in your life, okay? Could be that someone's offering you something and you're still stuck in your past and you're not able to take that decision. That is what I feel. Let's clarify each of these cards. Let's see what is the heartache about. see what is the heartache about. Ace of Cups and Queen of Cups. Okay, so you were emotional about something very much and probably it didn't work out. Let's see Dry Dessert. King of Swords and the World and the Ace of Wands followed by Two of Cups. You're worried about a connection probably, and this person is being ultra cold to you, but this person will come back. This person also has feelings for you. But maybe they're not able to express it the way you want. Because I'm seeing you in a lot of cups energy and your person being in a lot of sword energy. So there is a basic difference in energy here. Okay. I feel that it will come to you. Provided you get out of this mental conflict. Let me clarify the mental conflict. What is the mental conflict here? The Hanged Man, the Wheel of Fortune, and Nine of Pentacles. Okay, the conflict could be that this person gives you mixed signals and you don't know what to believe. So your advice is to not believe anything until it is very articulately expressed in front of you. Okay? I see that to be a reason why you are confused. That your heart says that no, this person is also equally involved. But you're probably in front of you, you're not able to see enough reasons. Or you're not able to see enough clarity in front of you that yes, this is true. Okay? So the advice here is that you are overthinking. If you're not able to see any kind of proofs or as in any kind of, see, intuition is intuition, okay? A lot of people just believe in their intuition, they don't need any proofs. But if you are someone who has intuition and still needs proofs, then the proof here is not there. So now you decide, do you want to go with your intuition or you want to wait for the proofs? What do you want to do? That's the reason why you're conflicted. Let's see, what else? What's next in your journey? Four of Pentacles. Ace of Pentacles. Eight of Wands. Okay. Someone's going to reach out to you with a new offer. Is this going to be the same person? Let me see. Is this going to be the same person, universe? Yes. This person could reach out to you. Provided you get into this mindset of nurturing your own self. Right now what you're doing is you're putting yourself in a spot and being sad and anxious. That is not going to help you in any way, pile number three. Okay? You got to just guard yourself up for some time. I told you, the first thing is take some time off to understand what's making you sad and then socialize with people. Don't make yourself a loner. Okay? Allow yourself to open up and to grow and to be mature and to feel happy. Right now, what you're doing is you're making your whole world around this situation, which is not the advice. Okay? Stop doing that. Let's see what else is next in your journey. What's next in your journey? I have the Four of Cups. Stop being a loner. Yeah, you got to go out. You got to step out. Because here I'm seeing that you're just making yourself so alone that nobody can reach out to you. That is the problem. you got to stop suppressing your feelings so much. Like, as in, you're living or you're like dwelling yourself in the heartbreak and you're beating yourself up around it. The advice is please go ahead and socialize as much as you can, because that will liberate you. That will make you feel better. Okay? That is what I'm seeing here. Let's see what is the advice for you. Advice for pile number three. Advice for pile number three is again breathe. I had this for pile two as well. A message in a bottle. I did see this, that somebody will reach out to you. If you've been waiting for someone, this person will reach out to you. Okay, probably in the next 6 to 10 days, this person will reach out to you. You first got to just work on yourself and make yourself happy. You can't dwell in this feeling of sadness for so long that it just becomes your perpetual feeling. It doesn't work like that. Okay, pile three. All right, so that's what I have for you guys. Also, guys, I've started a page for crystals, just in case if you want to know about it. It's MishiBlue_merchandise on Instagram. The link is there in the description. Please check that out if you want. And private readings are open, so you can reach out to me over there as well. And thank you so much for watching. Please let me know in the comments if this reading resonated with you. I'd really love to know that. Take care, and I shall see you soon. Bye.